You finally completed round after round of interviewing. You're in the final stages of the interviewing process, and now you're waiting for them. The ball is in the company's court. How can you tell how you did? Will an offer be coming? The wait can be nerve-wracking, but there are some indicators to tell you if the interview went well. And as a corporate recruiter, I'm gonna share with you some good signs that you got the job. Hey everybody, it's Brian from Life After Layoff, and today we're going to be talking about signs that your interview went well. Now, if you're looking for more tips on how to get through the interviewing process and ultimately land your dream job, consider hitting that subscribe button. I've got weekly tips and tricks planned, all from an insider's perspective. You see, I'm a corporate recruiter and talent acquisition professional with over 20 years of experience interviewing and hiring thousands of people into some of the world's most prestigious and well-known companies. And I'm gonna share some of those insider tips today, right here in this video. So if you go through a long and arduous interview process, the last step, obviously, is to know if you got the job or not. At this point in time, you've likely invested hours of time, energy, and even money interviewing for this opportunity, all trying to figure out if this is the perfect opportunity and the right fit for you. Now, it's important to note that during the interviewing process, the company's also potentially talking to 2 to 3 other candidates. As they wrap up their interviewing process, they all sit down and compare notes, and they look for things like motivational fit, technical fit, whether or not you have the potential to be promoted, and even what your rate of pay would be. All with the goal of deciding who would be most worthy of an offer. In some cases, there might even be more than one candidate, but you want to make sure that you're the first candidate selected. Now, you've likely gone through multiple rounds of interviews and you've put your best foot forward. How can you tell if you've impressed the interview team enough to put you to the top of the list? So here's some signs that the interview went well and an offer might be coming. The first sign is if the interview lasted longer than expected. Most interviews are scheduled for 45 minutes to maybe an hour in length. Usually the interviewer is working off of some sort of an interview guide, so they have specific questions that they're looking to get through in their allocated time. Now say you're really hitting it off with this interviewer and things are just really flowing. The next thing you know, they're losing track of time and all of a sudden they realize that they've only got 10 minutes left and they've only gone through 20% of their interview. That's actually a good sign because that means that you hit it off with the interviewer and things are going well. And if that's the case, you're doing a great job of making it more of a dialogue and you're establishing great rapport. Another sign that things are going well is positive feedback. Now, as an interviewer, I routinely give my candidates positive feedback if I like where they're going with a particular question. If they're on the right track, I'll say subtle things like, hey, that's a great answer, or I really like how you approach that problem. But another great indicator is if the interviewer then expands upon your answer and relates it to a problem that they're facing in their department. So if you get them to really expand and get excited by your answer and how they think that you can apply that to theirs, that's a great sign that things are going well. So that's why it's so important to understand the challenges that the position is solving so that you can tailor your answers to really give the interviewers all of the necessary information that they need to select you as the candidate. Now here's the thing, if you get positive feedback early in the interview, it actually gives you a little bit of wiggle room because what you've essentially started to do is build rapport and you're gonna get a little bit more benefit of the doubt from the interviewer. So not only will the interviewer look at you with a higher degree of confidence, but you should also begin to feel a little bit more confident yourself in delivering answers that you know are hitting the mark. So look for that positive feedback. That's a great indicator that things are going well. Another thing to look for is how complimentary the interview team was after the interview. Now, after the interview concludes, you should be able to get a gauge from the interviewer about how things went based on their interaction with you as they leave the room. If they're complimentary and genuinely seemed excited to meet you, then it's a pretty good indicator that things went well. Pay especially close attention to how the interactions went with your direct hiring manager. This is the person that you would be reporting to. If your hiring manager was really engaged in the interview with you and was asking all kinds of great questions about your background, excited about how they might translate to their department, that's a really positive sign. And if you feel that they're really trying to sell you on the opportunity, look at that as an even better sign because they're trying to get you engaged and excited about their opportunity because essentially they're having to sell you the same time you're selling them. So it really pays dividends to establish that rapport early in the interviewing process. Now, another thing to look for as a positive indicator is if after the final interview is over, I as the recruiter call you and say, hey, we actually want to connect you with the department lead. Now, you might be thinking, oh, here goes another interview. Why couldn't they get me to talk to this person to begin with? But here's the thing. Usually when you get to the point where you're talking to the department lead, this might be the vice president of your operation. But if we connect you to the boss's boss, you know that that's a good sign. You're in the final stages. Because the boss's boss only usually wants to talk to the final candidate just to give that last blessing. They just want to ensure that you're aligned to their departmental goals and that you would be a good addition to their broader team. So if you get this call, consider this to be a great sign that things are going really well in the interviewing process. Now, you should still take this interview very seriously. but keep doing what you're doing and you should be fine. Now, the next thing to look for is if they're actively trying to sell you the opportunity. Now, you've probably experienced this throughout the interviewing process and in particular with the hiring manager, but if they're selling you the opportunity and trying to get you to see the big picture, it's a good sign that they look at you as a potential contributor to their group. Because if we get to that offer, we want to make sure that you're as engaged as we are. So on candidates that we feel are particularly strong, we'll spend extra time really trying to sell them on the bigger vision, how they fit into the organization, and what potential career path we see for them. Your hiring manager may even discuss specific projects that they envision you working on. And you may even get introduced to other team members or people in the broader organization that you might have direct interaction with. And not only that, they may also be trying to sell you the benefits of working for the company, what their compensation packages are, and what their specific benefits package looks like. With the goal being is as you leave the interview, they want you to feel as excited about the opportunity as they feel about you. So if you're being sold by the company on why this position would be a great opportunity for you, look at that as a very positive sign. And now another sign to look at is if the recruiter follows up with you very shortly after the interview on some other things. Now, typically after an interview that goes particularly well, the hiring manager will come back to me and say, hey, can you follow up with them just to see how they thought things went? So a lot of times I'll pick up a phone and call you and say, hey, how did it go? What are your thoughts? Is this something that you can see yourself doing? Now, if I'm asking you those questions, I'm actively probing you to gauge your interest level, because I'm going to go back to the hiring manager and say, yeah, it seems like they actually are pretty interested in the role. And I might also need some additional information. Maybe the interview team forgot to ask something critical in their decision-making process, and I'm trying to follow up with you to bridge that gap. Maybe I'm calling to dig to see if you have other opportunities pending that we need to be in front of. But again, if I follow up with you and I ask you the very specific question of how did it go and do you see yourself as part of this team, consider that to be a very solid sign. The last sign that I want to talk about is if we start to talk salary expectations. Now, earlier in the process, I'm going to do that as part of my pre-screen with you. We're going to cover what your salary expectation is. But as we get a little closer to the offer process, if I call you up and start asking you specific details around what it is that you really need to see in a compensation package, consider that to be a very strong sign that an offer is coming. Because we're trying to put together a competitive package for you in order to get you to sign on the dotted line. And if you have other opportunities brewing, I might use that as an opportunity to light a fire under my team to try to get them to move quicker. So there you have it. There's 7 signs that your interview went well. If you notice these things, you can expect an offer might be coming real soon. But now's not the time to rest on your laurels. Make sure you keep on applying for jobs, building your networks, and aggressively pursuing opportunities that interest you until you have an offer in hand. Listen, if you're getting to the interview phase, but you're not getting the offer, don't worry too much. The fact that you're getting interviews alone means that you're doing something right. Just a few minor tweaks will get you across the finish line. If you need additional help, that's what I specialize in. I've got a website called alifeafterlayoff.com. It is loaded with tips and tricks on how to get more noticed by recruiters, how to get through each step of the interviewing process, ultimately how to make sure that you're the candidate selected, and then help you negotiate the best possible offer. And I've also got a training course called the Ultimate Layoff Bootcamp. It is 7 hours of dedicated training. It takes you through those same steps, but in a very detailed, methodical manner. It's all from behind the scenes, so I give you all of my knowledge as a corporate recruiter and help you position yourself to be the best possible candidate. Something to check out, I'll leave a link for that as well. If you found value in this video, I'd appreciate a thumbs up because that actually helps other people find the same content that they're looking for in their job journey. Happy job hunting, and we'll see you on the next one.